Hello fellow tankers, bonjour amis tankistes. In this video, we will address the Stalingrad map, which is one of the most interesting and most complex maps in the game. The reason for that is twofold. The first reason is that it seems that the sea belongs naturally to the green side, because the sea is closer to the green spawn. And that A belongs to the red side, but very often you will find that the red side will ultimately capture C, or conversely that the green side may capture A, so that the two teams will have to balance their force in between defending their natural cap and pushing toward the enemy cap. So that's the first reason of the complexity of this map. The second main reason is the fact that the fight for B is very unbalanced. Let me remind you first that to ultimately win a battle, you will have to control typically at least two caps, and that's why obviously B will play also an important role, and it happens that the fight for B is very very unbalanced, which in particular makes the conquest map where B is the only cap very unbalanced. The reason for this unbalance is that this area here is simply horrible fighting area. The reason for that is that yes, you have a lot of cover thanks to these buildings, but very often you can actually be spotted in these buildings, you can be shot in your turret, but also the problem is that in all these buildings you have a very narrow field of view and very bad shooting spots, whereas the red side here has a very good area to shoot at B from various angles. The red side also can cap B very easily in a very safe area here in the lower ground, whereas the green side will usually cap B in this area, but unfortunately, this capping spot here can be shot at from so many angles by the red tanks that it's very dangerous to cap B if you have still a lot of red tanks around B. In addition, this street is the only access of the green side to B. This shooting spot here is very bad, very dangerous. Again, can be shot from every area, and very often it would be very hard for the green side to access B from this area. So this feature, so why this feature is very important, it means that if the green side wants to ultimately control B, essentially they should not come from this area, but they should come from this area. So that means that in the beginning of the game, the vast majority of green tanks should go towards C and try to control this area. The game, this battle, is won in this area. And we see that means that to counter this green move, the red tanks also have to be in force in this area. First, they should obviously fast cap B early in the game. They should, of course, a few tanks should go to A, but the majority also of red tanks should really essentially aim for C. And the idea, the main motivation will be to keep control of this area, because if the green tanks capture C and then take control of this area, they will Control B. Essentially, by capping B in the same low ground spot where the red tanks usually cap it. So the green side will control this area and will even put the red spawn in danger. So you may say, okay, but maybe the same thing is happening in A, but the reason why it's not happening in A is that the terrain here is so bad that essentially, once you, even if you have a control A, you have a very limited number of options, where once you have control this area, you have so many options, and it will be very hard to for the team not controlling this area to win. Let me actually briefly address the fight on A. So obviously the access to A from the red side is pretty straightforward. From the green side, very often people come from the this area, which is very bad. I find the direct approach here by using this main road much more efficient, much faster, much well covered, and the terrain is much better than in this area. But anyway, again, let's say that the green side has captured A, then yes, they can probably come in this area, but that will not facilitate their approach to B, because again, from here they will not be able to cross, because you will have a lot of red tanks in this area. So you may say that maybe the green side can push the red spawn, but again, the terrain here is definitely not favorable to the team which would push from A, and in fact the red spawn will not be in danger. Conversely, if the red side capture A and try to push the red spawn, again the terrain here is so bad and this attack will not be very effective, and meanwhile maybe they will advance slowly toward the red spawn, but if they concentrate too many forces on A, essentially the green side will capture B and C by a very powerful move from C and controlling this area. So very often on this map, despite the map being slightly, let's say, more favorable to the red side, very often you will find the red side lose, because essentially they lose control of this area, and they have much too many forces on A, probably ultimately aiming to go to the green spawn, which again early in the game is simply, sorry to say, but a completely stupid move. Don't go to the enemy spawn in the beginning of the game. The enemy has a lot of spawns, a lot of tanks. You are not fighting in the area which matters, and on this map you win the game in this area. And let me also again insist on why there is no symmetry between A and C. It's because this area is a very, very good fighting area, whereas this area is simply a very bad fighting area. I will address the fight on C during the video, so let me start the replay. I am playing my 5.3 Italian lineup. I'm spinning the new Italian copypasta tanks, while my two squad mates are playing their 5-7 lineup, and we are in a 6-7 battle. So that means that I'm starting with my M18, the 4-7 tank, in a 6.7 battle. So obviously I will meet much stronger tanks, and I will have to be a bit careful. So let me first comment my approach to C. stop here in a second. So let me change the view. So very often when I'm coming from to sea, I'm coming from behind this pile of dirt and this fuel tank. And very often I'm taking a little break here to assess the situation. But here I'm in a fast tank and I'm hoping to be able to reach this fuel tank. And on this map, you should use this fuel tank to cap the sea from both sides, from the green side on this side, and obviously from the red side on the other side. Let me comment on the fight on sea. So very often when I'm capping sea in this area, very often my goal is to push to control this area and ultimately to control B, and even from the green side to cap B, where the red tanks will usually cap B in the beginning of the game. Here you see, by the way, that the first mistake of the red side is not to have sent at least one tank to fast cap B and to start the ticket bleed. And you see that not too many tanks, red tanks, came in this area, and most red tanks went to A, which is definitely a mistake in this battle. Let me mention that if you have a red tank and you want to attack C, my advice is that you don't come where this M41 is coming from, which is potentially very dangerous. It happens that we have also very few green tanks in this area, but it's very easy to be sniped when you are here, and you don't have, because of the terrain here, you will have to climb, and you need a very big gun, very good gun depression to fight efficiently. So from the right side, I like to come either from this street here, this road, or from behind this building, which will give you a good shooting angles toward the green tanks arriving to sea, or even tanks on the sea side. Let me mention that I used to like the approach of sea from the green side through this road, until I realized that it was essentially ineffective compared to this this approach. So here, let me go back to the replay. Deciding to go straight to sea and not to stop, and I'm losing my gunner in the process. So let me accelerate, I'm capping. M41, avenging my gunner, and I mentioned that it's very good to come from this road when you are on the right side, and from the green side when you want to push toward the north, you should also come from this road. This road is offers you a very very good approach. The reason is that you can essentially not be flank from the right. You have essentially only to look at tanks in front and on the left, mostly on the left. So I have broken the gun of this M26. I have wrecked its turret. So now I don't want to leave him the time to repair, and I'm charging. Now I realize that I have two T26 coming for me. I'm trying to find some cover. I realize that I don't have enough cover here, so I'm trying to escape. Of course, that's the drawback of using a 4-7 tank in a 6-7 battle. Let me comment about what's happening on the map. You will so here essentially the fact that we have now controlled this area, that essentially very few red tanks came in this area. They didn't fast cap B in the beginning, and now we have green tanks pushing toward this area. So a very good move from our team, and you see only a very few tanks in our team going toward there, which is very good. Four tanks is well enough, and I like this heavy tank which is going this way, which is much better than actually being in these buildings where the fight is very very cumbersome, to say the least. So now let me accelerate. I'm taking a plane. And since this T-26 E1 is a too formidable opponent for me, for my little M18, I'm deciding to rocket it. My plane is wrecked, but I still succeed in killing this T-26. So here I will try to exploit the... First, I'm anticipating this M36 climbing on this hill, which is not a good move. And I make this pretty nice shot. And my goal now is to exploit this building and the agility of my tank to essentially being like a little mosquito flying around the enemy and biting every now and then. Coming back in a plane, let me accelerate that. So that gives me a good aerial view. So you see that now the enemy decides to go fight for this area, but it's a bit too late. They should have gone there much faster. Here I will kill the panther. I will not kill the tiger, and I'm going back, little mosquito. This jumbo kills my buddy Abs. I'm waiting for him before he emerges on the other side of the building, and I see now that there is a M4 typo which is rushing my other squad mate. And I kill him in between the two buildings. So that's a pretty good start with this M18. 8 kills in a 6-7 battle. But meanwhile, you have an even smaller tank, Panzerfriel, which very courageously is uncapping B. It's very easy to access to B from the right side. Trying to blind shot Panther, but does nothing. And here I completely hesitate while aiming at this Panzerfriel. Unfortunately, it's also due to the fact that my cross was jumping because of obstacles close to the cross. That's a very annoying feature. I already mentioned that in it's a very annoying feature in the game. And but this poor Panzerfriel, well done, well to him, even if I don't approve to take troll tanks, low BR troll tanks in high BR, higher BR battle. He did a better job than some of his teammates. And so at this point, the enemy has lost a lot of tanks, and especially because they came too late in this area at the corner between B and C. Let me accelerate here. My plane will do absolutely nothing. Yes, ISU will be killed first by my squad mate. And if you have a spawn campers going to your spawn, it's very they don't have good positions actually, and they can be very easily sniped from the side. So at this point the gameplay is finished. The enemy is essentially running out of spawn points, and so let me just summarize the fight on this battle. For the two teams, the area where you win the battle is this area between B and C, which allows you actually to control B. So that means that even the red side in the beginning of the game should obviously fast cap B, something that the red team didn't do in this battle, but also should try to take good positions close to C, so along these buildings that I mentioned, coming from this street that I mentioned, and avoiding the middle, here the middle where the M41 came previously. And essentially in this battle, the red team lost because they let the green team essentially control this area. And again, the terrain on A is so bad that it's actually not a very good fighting field. And essentially after you get A, you don't have anything to do except for the red side to go to the spawn. But as you can see, it's not a great success. Or for the green side to occupy this area, but which will not make their fight for B easier, because to get B you have to control this area, and obviously it's easier to control this area if you also control C. So I thank you for watching this tutorial. In a future video I will address the conquest maps on this Stalingrad map, and present gameplay on one of the conquest version of this map. And well, I encourage you to support this channel, and also advise it to your friends. And see you on the battlefield. À bientôt sur le champ de bataille.